Hey y'all, it's Biscuit. How is everybody doing? Hopefully you all are having a great day wherever you are. So today's video is going to be another nail haul. Your girl has been shopping throughout the month of November and a little bit of December, but you're probably gonna see these videos in January because I've been behind and busy and Christmas and work and all this other stuff. So I believe that I have said this before, that for Black Friday and for Christmas, I decided to spread my money amongst small nail businesses, Black-owned businesses, women-owned businesses, and also other brands that I have been watching or following on Instagram, TikTok, and I just wanted to show my support and try out their products. So that is what you will be seeing for the month of January are my purchases that I did for Christmas time. And I decided not to go with like those bigger brands like Not Polish and Young Nails this time around. I wanted to spread the love to my smaller businesses and also try out their products. So this company is called Dime Nail Supply, and I saw that they were having mystery scoops for Black Friday. So I was like, okay, let me go ahead and get in on this action. So I ended up purchasing two scoops, and this is everything that I got in my scoops. So her scoops were $20 a scoop, so I ended up spending $40, and I believe shipping was like $12.99, and then of course with taxes and stuff it came out to $57 shipped. So I'm gonna go through everything with you all here. So, of course, I got some nice, cute charms, and I love the colors in these, so I'm definitely excited. I do have a few of those stars, but I also have, like, a mix with that in there, but that's definitely really, really cute. And I also got these blue charms, which I thought were also pretty cute, and definitely can't wait to use these on the nails. That little heart sucker is really, really cute. So yeah, and plus I have enough foil containers I can go ahead and put my charms away. And this next item I also got were some more charms, but they were in the pink color. And these are also adorable as well. That almost reminds me of like a freeze pop. You have some buttons, ice cream, donuts. I have a little mini frying pan and some hearts and stuff. So I thought those were really, really cute as well. So moving on from the charms, in my scoop I did get some of her foil gel. So here I am just taking some foil because I'm going to test out her gel and see how it works. So I am going to get a swatch stick. We're going to go ahead and apply this Dime Nail Supply foil gel, and I'm going to put it in my lamp for 60 seconds. And then as soon as it's out the lamp, I don't like to wait. I just go ahead and apply it while it's fresh out the lamp. I know some people do like to wait like an extra 10 seconds or maybe 30 seconds just to get it nice and tacky, which there's nothing wrong with that. You can do that as well, but I like to apply mine as soon as it comes out the lamp because I figured it's nice and warm and will adhere very nicely to the foil. So actually this foil gel is really, really good. I'm not trying to say that I'm surprised, but y'all know how I feel about my iMethod Beauty foil gel. I still use that. I still play around in foils. I have like 4 books of foils. Okay, now I'm definitely excited to have this though. So it was really, really nice. So if you want, you can use your finger, you can use this silicone tool to help you press the foil into the gel, but the transfer is definitely on point. All right, so moving right along, we are going to go ahead and get into these gel polishes. And this first one is a nice nude color. You've actually probably seen me use this color in a previous video, if it's up already, but I just didn't tell you all where it was from. But this one is, I believe, S6, which is a beautiful nude color. And when I say this nude is nuding, yeah. This is a good nude. I definitely like it. So here we are with, I think this was 05, which is a nice lime yellow color. And this one is obviously more on the transparent side. You will have to build this color up if you want it to be a little bit more opaque than this, but you can also get away with using this as a jelly color. So it's really, really pretty, almost giving off highlighter vibes. Okay, so I probably will be, I think I did at least 2 or 3 coats just to show you how to build it up if you choose to do so. But overall, these polishes have a nice consistency. I love the brush on the polishes because it'll fit nice in the cuticle area when you are polishing. So yeah, I'm definitely excited about these gel polishes. And if you notice, this top was actually missing from the bottle, so the handle on the bottle. So I went ahead and fixed that with some nail glue so that way it wouldn't pop off again. All right, so let's get into this last item, which is an acrylic powder in a 1 ounce jar. This one was called Lava, and her acrylic actually applied really, really nice. This one in particular, I think maybe some might have spilled out of it because it wasn't really full to the top, and not that it has to be as long as it equals out to 1 ounce, but it was kind of a little chalky for me, or it definitely had a lot of pigment in it, which I don't mind. But it was, it has to be stirred up. I actually mixed it up. I shook it because I felt like it was more pigment in there than acrylic. But, you know, you can always fix that, and you can just add more clear acrylic to any of your powders if you have that issue. So here, after I have mixed it, you will see me testing it out again just to make sure that it's thoroughly mixed. And then once I put that swatch on the napkin, I'm going to go in and put the acrylic inside of my swatch stick. I like to do this for my swatch sticks because it just looks more aesthetically pleasing instead of having it on top of the swatch stick. But if you prefer it on the top, that is perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with that. I just like mine inside because it just looks more aesthetically pleasing to me. The color is very, very beautiful. Again, it's very, very pigmented. But what I will say is that I would add some clear to this just to kind of thin out that pigment a little bit, and also not to make it seem so chalky, just a little bit. But I definitely am going back for more powders. Again, I think that it's just a maybe it could be the vibrancy of the color. But yeah, so that is everything that I got from Dime Nail Supply. I definitely will be back. If you all are interested, I will leave all of her information down in the description box where you can go check out her website. She does do other things other than just scoops. She sells everything individually as well. So if you are interested in showing support, all of that will be in the description box below. Okay, so I also decided to include this in the video as well, which this is what I was talking about. If you prefer to swatch your swatch sticks on top, there is nothing wrong with that. But for the sake of, you know, me having my swatches on my ring, I like to swatch on the inside. But I did go ahead and do a swatch on the top of the nail just to show you how well this acrylic applied. And again, like I said, just because it is more on the chalkier side, the acrylic applied very, very well. So like I said, I am going back to support, but you know, there's always fixes with everything. So yeah, I mean, the color is beautiful. It's really, really good. And again, it applied very, very nicely on top of the nail, and I can't say nothing bad about this at all. It was really, really nice to work with. I'm just looking at the application as you all are. I'm like, man, this is a nice acrylic. So this is everything that I got in my two scoops from Dime Nail Supply. I will leave all the information down in the description box if you are interested. As always, thank you all so much for your love and support. And if you enjoyed this video, give this video a thumbs up. And your girl will catch you in her next video. Bye, y'all.